In this video, we are going to do the editorial analysis of the Hindu newspaper dated 25th of May 2021. The first article in the editorial page is Character Challenge. It talks about the sender's directive to Twitter to remove manipulated media tag on posts, and it says that it is illegal. Twitter is a private entity whose relationship with users is guided by its own terms of services. The article talks about whether it is legal for the central government to give such a direction. The IT Act that empowers the government to regulate content does not give it the power to order the removal of a label. So basically it says that it is not backed by law, and additionally the government move raises serious concerns regarding arbitrary censorship and transparency. The next article is Losing Time, Puducherry Needs a Full-Fledged Government as Coronavirus Cases Rise. The Chief Minister of Puducherry is N. Rangasamy, who belongs to NR Congress. NR Congress has 10 MLAs, BJP has 6 MLAs, and 3 more has been appointed recently by the governor. There has been some differences between NR Congress and BJP about portfolio sharing, and the article suggests to resolve them quickly, especially since the pandemic was tightening its grip. Now let's look at the map of Puducherry. We can see that there are 4 districts and are spread across different states. The one on the left of your screen is Mahi district, which is enclosed within the state of Kerala. Moving in anticlockwise direction, you can see the Karaikal district in Tamil Nadu, and the next one is Puducherry district, and the next one is Yanam district. These 4 were part of a French colony and became a part of India after independence, and is currently together under Puducherry Union Territory, even though they are separated by geography. The state assembly of Puducherry has 33 seats, out of which 30 are selected by the people and 3 are appointed by the central government. The capital is located at Pondicherry, and they share the Madras High Court with the Tamil Nadu. Next article we are going to talk about is a September exit, Afghanistan at the crossroads. The Washington Desired conference to be hosted by the UN in Istanbul, Turkey, remains suspended due to the reluctance of Afghan's Taliban. Presently, they have expressed an openness to attend the Istanbul summit with the condition that final outcome will be achieved in the meeting that will take place in Doha. US President Joe Biden is trying to withdraw all the troops on September 11, even without any power sharing deal between current Afghan government and the Taliban. Since the announcement of an exit date by US troops, Afghanistan continues to witness deadly attacks across its provinces. For example, multiple blasts outside a girls' school in Kabul recently was the worst terror attack in Afghanistan in a year. By doing such arbitrary acts of violence, the Taliban are demonstrating that they are capable of seizing by military force what is not offered to them on the negotiating table. The article also talks about the US military. The US military presence in Afghanistan for almost 2 decades had kept US reliant on Pakistan for operational and other support. And Pakistan has also used this dependence of US government effectively. With the disappearance of this lethal dependence, Pakistan faces an uphill task in conducting a viable Afghan policy. An essential element of Mr. Biden's plan is to make Afghan President Ghani agree to dissolve his government and set up a new governing system that would include the Taliban, which could finally decide the future distribution of power and changes to the Afghan constitution. But Mr. Ghani refuses to step down for an interim regime to take over, insisting that a new government should emerge through elections in which he promises not to run. Apart from the support from Pakistan, Taliban also draw support from a wide variety of regional powers, including Russia, China, Iran. But these countries want them to moderate its position. Also, if you look at China, China has also benefited by the US military position. America's military presence in Afghanistan has suppressed many terrorist groups which threaten China directly or Beijing-friendly countries in Central Asia. India has been the key regional backer of the Ghani government, supporting an Afghan-led peace process. New Delhi rightly fears a Taliban-dominated regime in Kabul might allow Pakistan to dictate Afghanistan's India policy. Since India does not have a good relationship with Taliban, a government that is Taliban-dominated will favor Pakistan more than India. So this is the current global and regional political situation centering around Afghanistan. Afghanistan. Now we look at the next article, the scale of Gujarat's mortality crisis. Data from the civil registration system in Gujarat shows large increases in mortality, consistent with multiple accounts of the unreliability of official COVID-19 death reporting in the state. Taking Gujarat's projected population in 2021 about 6.98 crore, you would expect about 82,500 deaths in a 71-day period. They have also used registered death between 2015 to 2018 for this calculation. Using the registered deaths between 2015 to 18 also reveals a similar estimate. But between March 1 and May 10, 2021, 1.23 lakh registered deaths in Gujarat has happened, which is 50% higher than expected from baseline estimates. Moreover, the current COVID-19 wave may have caused delays in the registrations too. So the number is only expected to rise above the current value. Most of these deaths may directly reflect the unreported COVID-19 deaths, and some may reflect the overwhelmed healthcare facilities or worsening economic conditions. A single global tender for vaccine procurement. Many state governments have resorted to floating global tenders for COVID-19 vaccines. So the article goes on to criticize the current vaccine policy. Supplies are projected to achieve substantial levels only by August 2021. Extending the vaccination towards this age group, it should have concentrated only on the high-risk age category. And whenever adequate supply of vaccines are available, the government should have extended the vaccination program to other age groups. The next point is uniform vaccine prices for all states can prevent exploitation. The states are competing in an international market. It is always better for central government to procure the vaccines together rather than each state government to fight between themselves and with the international market. The states will have to procure doses at higher rates than a single national purchaser would. The article then talks about how polio was done. The center was procuring all the vaccines, and the duty of the state governments was to administer them. The article recommends the same methods of polio vaccination to be followed currently. It ends by talking about the rights-based approach in healthcare, revolving around accessibility, availability, and affordability. And it says that the significance of these magnifies during an emergency of the proportions we are seeing today. Now we have come to the vocabulary building section. We will look at different words. The first word is disparage. It means represent as being of little worth. Next word is indisposed, which means slightly unwell. Next word is pyrrhic. It means won at too great a cost to have been worthwhile for the victor. The next word is notoriety, the state of being famous or well known for some bad quality or deed. The next word is pertinent, relevant or applicable to a particular matter. Concomitant, it means naturally accompanying or associated. If the video was useful, consider subscribing to this channel and sharing it to others. Stay safe and see you again.